Find out why a TV interview is kind of like a first date. I've seen it many times. You have someone who is eager to get on TV. They want to talk about their expertise. But then when the time comes, they don't know what to say. Hey, that's okay. But you got to respect the medium of television and understand how to speak on it. So let's go over a basic tip. I say, imagine that you are on a first date. First dates are a little awkward. You don't know the other person that well, and you're trying to make a good first impression. Often, first dates go a couple different ways. One is you talk too much. You're just blabbing away about everything you know. Aren't I cool? Aren't I great? It gets boring for the other person because they can't get a word in. The other side of the spectrum, well, that sees you pretty much answer things yes or no. Oh, so do you like walking on the beach? Yes. Do you like sunsets? Yes. Now, perhaps in this instance, you could give just a little bit more. Yeah, I like sunsets. Man, the other day I saw a great one. It was like the sky was painted. Or, oh, I do like walking on the beaches. One of my favorite beaches around here is like this. Oh, maybe sometime you'd like to see it. See, hey, first date, that's some good stuff. You're giving a little bit of information, you're not giving too much, and you're involving the other person. Same thing can happen in your interview. So if you're being asked about your expertise, now often I talk to people about productivity. So if the host was to ask me a question like, can we really improve our productivity? I wouldn't just want to say, yes. Then it cuts tossed back to them and they're kind of like, oh my gosh, I got to go to the next question. And they realize that this person is not going to be helping them much in the interview, not being a good partner. So if someone were to say, well, can someone improve their productivity? I would say, yes, they can. Many times I've seen where people have been able to take simple steps that have improved their overall productivity, both at work and at home. What I gave there was about a, I don't know, 8 to 10 second soundbite, but it's something that they're able to use, something I'm able to be proud of, and they can ask, well, tell me more about that. When you just answer a yes or a no, doesn't give them any room to go anywhere. They're just gonna quickly go through the list, or they may start to filibuster with their questions. Watch for that sometime. If you ever see the interviewer asking really long questions, it's kind of because they've given up on you as an interview topic, and they're just trying to get through the segment as much as possible. So think about those phrases that you can say, 8 to 10 seconds for each one, that you can have in your back pocket. So if someone even asks a question about, hey, Ken, you're a productivity expert, why is the sky blue? And I could say, well, you know, there's a scientific reason for that. But what I know about productivity is, and I go to my canned response. It makes their life easier, makes your expertise shine, and there's a better chance you'll be asked back again. So think about that. You're on a first date. Make it an impressive one. For more about this, go to helpwithvideo.com. All sorts of video tips, how to, you got it. Right there on the site. Also want to remind you, find out more about me, go to the YouTube channel I have. Just like my name, go to YouTube, Ken Okel, O-K-E-L, and you'll find my channel. All right, that's all the time we have for now. I'm Ken Okel. Take care.